What's going on, everybody? My name is What's Wrong, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to a brand new episode of the 100% completion guide for LEGO Marvel Avengers. Today, we're going to be tackling the 13th level in the game, or at least it is the 13th level for us, and that would be Korea Prospects. So this should be a pretty fun level because this is the level where the Avengers really go at it with Ultron over a certain delivery of a Vision body, so to speak, or a Vision to be body, so to speak. Nonetheless, ladies and gents, let's try this again. Alrighty, what is going on, everybody? My name is What's Wrong, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to a brand new 100% completion guide for LEGO Marvel Avengers. Today, we are tackling the 13th level, or at least that is the 13th level for us, because again, you can obviously play them in a different order. But for us, this is the 13th level titled Korea Prospect. Now, you will notice that going into this level, I've already got some of the items unlocked by mistake when we were playing it the first time around. So, for example, instead of just having one gold brick, which is what you should be at right now, we actually have two because we rescued Stan the Man Lee. Don't worry, though. I will still show you how to do that, so do not be concerned about that. Now, on top of all that, of course, we will be gathering 10 minikits, even though we have only two right... Oh, sorry. We already have two unlocked, so keep that in mind. There's also three character tokens, a red power brick, and we need to reach the true Avenger ranking, which means collecting a certain amount of studs in the level in order to get there. Now, keep in mind, I'm using a multiplier, so that will make things a lot easier. As far as how to activate multipliers, all you have to do is pause, go to extras once you've actually unlocked the multiplier, and just turn them all on, and that will add to your score substantially. So you might be wondering, how many studs do I need to get to the true Avenger ranking? Well, that would be 140,000, so not that much. Whatsoever is what I meant to say, though. So with that in mind, let's see how the areas break down in terms of where the items are. So it seems like Area A offers only one minikit, so sounds pretty easy. Area B offers three minikits and two character tokens. And then last but certainly not least, the final area is where we're going to be kind of doing substantial amount of work, where we need to get six minikits, a red brick, rescue Stanley, and a character token. So a lot of work to be done this entire level. So let's get rocking and let's get a rolling for today. Why don't we start with Sam Wilson, Captain America. Let's do this thing. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Rhea Hill breakdown, so she will give us a little bit of an idea of where we are currently in the storyline and what is occurring, so to speak. So there's, of course, Ultron and Iron Man and Black Widow going at it.
Into cellular regeneration is second to none. Her latest creation, located at the Yujin Genetics Lab, is
the Cradle. That's the name of it. I was going to call it the Cradle, but I thought they had a name for the actual body.
By the way, the image that you're seeing is a Yujin Genetics truck, not the Cradle. They kind of look a little different. If Ultron got his hands on the Cradle, then there's no telling what he might be planning to do with it.
Good point. Well, his whole idea was to obviously download his brain into the Cradle because it's a pretty powerful body, as we see later on when the Vision takes control of it.
Artificial intelligence.
Oh, yeah. So this is, of course, after the events of Barton Farm, when they arrive to the farm to just kind of have a little bit of a breather, regroup, and figure out what do they need to do next in order to stop Ultron. Who knew that Tony's such a big fan of chickens, I guess. He's just like, I'm panicking, and I'm freaking out. Uh-oh, not good. Oh, this is such a good scene here. He's like, check that out. Yeah, that's right. I love Steve Rogers' just complete demeanor. He's just like, yeah, I'm just not dealing with this guy anymore. Let's just walk away. And that's how Civil War starts.
Has anyone been in contact with Helen Cho?
Cellular cohesion.
There it is. There's the Cradle itself.
Initiate the consciousness stream. We're uploading your cerebral matrix.
Ooh.
I can read him. He's dreaming.
Oh, he's dreaming of using a chainsaw on bunnies? How dare he?
You're a madman.
Yeah.
Who's incoming?
Guys!
We have to move.
Oh, here we go. So this is where the action picks right up. Yeah, he's not too happy. He was in an intense game of poker or something, it seemed like.
Stop it.
Stop it. right. Let's do this, Ultron, buddy. Man, this is such a well, like, executed scene, just in, even in Lego form. It looks so awesome. So there we are. We already have two Avenger ranking because, of course, again, multipliers make things very, very easy. All right, let's do this thing. Here we go. We don't want any leveling of any cities happening except for us completing this level, of course. All right, so what we're going to do here is we're going to switch to Captain America real quick. Drop into here and grab our first minikit. So again, it does say 3 minikits, but keep in mind that obviously going into this level, I already had 2 minikits unlocked, so that's why that showed up the way that it did. Do not pay attention to it whatsoever. Right now, you should just have 1 minikit, so do not be concerned. Okay, we need to take down 4 more, or 3 more, I guess. There we go. Ultron bots. Is that it? I think that's it. We took care of those guys. Hey, Natasha, I'd really, really appreciate that shield. If you could send that this way, that would be highly, highly, highly appreciated right about now. Get over here, dude. Bring it on. Look at those combos from Steve Rogers. Ultron's got nothing on us. Uh-oh. Ouch. Bring it on. Yeah, that's right. Fly away. Here we go, though. We're about to get barraged again by another swarm of Ultron bots. Now, you can make things a little bit easier on yourself if you can actually just knock them off the side here. You'll notice that that will typically take them down quite quickly, like that, for example. So, again, you do want to be careful yourself, though, because you can fly off the ledge as well. So if you're trying to do, like, a no-death run or something like that, you obviously want to be careful. All right, bring it on, Ultron. Yeah, I'd really appreciate that shield right about now. Whoa. Can we fire at him from here or not? I don't remember. Do we need to just, like, get super close? There we go. All right, please throw me the shield. I'd really appreciate that. Can't really defend myself right now. There we are. All right. Now things are going to be a lot easier to get around. Didn't I switch already? Could have sworn I switched. There we go. I thought I had control over Captain America already this whole time. I'm like, what's happening? And then I looked in the top left corner and I saw that we had Black Widow selected. I'm like, wait. Oh, look at that. Ultron taking a little bit of damage from the cars. That actually would have been a really cool scene in the film if, like, Captain America hits him with a shield or something and then he, like, runs face first into a car. That'd be pretty epic. It could be a really cool fight scene, maybe in a future film or something. Uh-oh, here we go. Now, this is going to be a lot easier because now we have the shield to take care of them very, very, very quickly. So we literally just need to tag them all, and there we are. It takes 1 second to take care of the entire swarm. All right, bring it on, dude. There we go. Smash him in the face with a shield. Unfortunately, it's not nearly as simple to take down Ultron. He definitely puts up quite a bit more of a fight. Well, maybe not. Wow, we are doing really well. I've never defeated him so quickly. This is awesome. There we are. Well, obviously, we haven't defeated him. When I say defeated him, I mean in this particular sequence. Not overall, because this is not how the Avengers Age of Ultron film ends. Just this fight on the truck, and Captain America wins. It's like, yay, guys, that's it. We didn't even need the Avengers for the whole fight. It was just me. Great. Excellent. Civil War. That's what starts it. Okay, that was dangerous. Come on, dude. Boom! Good shot. Do we need to tag him again? There we are. Get out of here. And hit him again.
Well, he's definitely unhappy. I'm gonna try and keep him that
way. All right, sounds good. You do that. We're gonna put this thing together, though. So I'm not sure if you want to do that. You probably want to focus on putting together this little shield transporter device. Here we go. Come on. Activate it. Cap. Hurry up, dude. You're getting shot by Ultron. Probably not fun, I'm guessing.
Right above you, Cap.
There we are. All right, excellent. Boom, boom, boom. Ooh, good. Good, good support there from Mr. Barton, a.k.a. Clint Barton, a.k.a. Hawkeye. Ooh.
Tickets.
Watch out, Stan. Alright, so that was Area A cleared out, 1 minikit, and of course a pretty lengthy boss fight, mini boss fight, against Ultron. So, Now that we've wrapped up that, we're going to be transported to Area B, which is going to be the one inside the train. So this is where we are headed next. Ooh, nice. Thank you, Quicksilver. Appreciate that, buddy. Was he paying him? I think he was, maybe. Stan? Okay, good. I was gonna say. Come on, Stan. You gotta pay attention, buddy. And give that a good little push. Yay, we did it. Awesome. Everything went great. Aw. Yay, drama.
You have the package. Get it to Stark. Go. Civilians in our path. Can you stop this thing?
She's like, not sure, but we can certainly try. Whoops. Yeah, not the smartest group of people there, huh? Having a picnic on the train tracks. I mean, come on, dude. Think. It's like just a little bit. All right, right here you can save. So pretty important little bit right there. You probably want to take advantage of that. So let's see. Let's use one of our new Iron Man figures or characters that we just got recently through some DLC. So we're going to go ahead and get rid of all that. And we get ourselves a nice little piece of Ultron there, because that is Ultron Prime. So the premier version of Ultron is now ours, which is very, very, very cool indeed. All right, so now we've assembled ourselves a little speed boost pad right here. So let me just get rid of this Ultron bot first. There we go. And we need a speedster character such as Quicksilver. You know what? Since he's a part of this level, let's use him for this. And he will help you enter the back of the train here. So while in the back of the train, we're going to go ahead and grab that minikit and then continue all the way to the very back of the train. And then you're going to need somebody that can help you with a little bit of the glass here. There we are. Excellent. And that is done. Fantastic. So before we leave this area, though, we're going to use the telekinetic abilities that we have right here to destroy the first of five citizen, I guess, luggages or something, if you'd call them. I'm not really sure what you'd call those specifically, but those particular little things there. Now, I will say that this is a really, really great spot, by the way, to get a bunch of studs. So you want to be destroying these little seats and stuff, because that's how you're going to earn a really, really, really good amount of studs for yourself. If you're having a very difficult time without the multipliers, this is where you want to be getting your studs from, is by destroying, first of all, these guys, because they will give you multipliers. And then additionally to that, the actual chairs and everything inside the train are pretty useful, and they will give you a really, really, really decent amount of stuff unlocked. All right, so now that we've cleared out that entire situation, let's fix up the train here. Once it's been fixed up, you can actually destroy these as well. So again, carry on. Since we're okay, we're just going to proceed now and continue onwards and forwards. All right, here we go. Watch out. So obviously right now, by the way, we've already got two of the luggages that we've been collecting cleared out. Okay, these guys are a little bit tougher than I thought they were going to be. There we go. Got rid of them. Now, do you have the detection ability? Yes, you do. Fantastic. And there's a bunch of luggage now. Probably not the best place to actually keep it. So there we are. We got ourselves another character unlocked. And I think that that is Komodo. I'm pretty sure that that's who it is. Not 100% certain, though. I'm not going to lie. All right. We have another piece of luggage right here. So let's go ahead and get rid of this thing. There we are. Excellent. And now we shall continue onwards and forwards. Down the train we go. Trying to just continuously travel onwards. Alright. Let me try to take these guys down. Maybe we could do a team-up move here. It could be nice. Boom! There we are! Whoa, that was awesome! Not only did we take all of them down, but we got a bunch of studs for that, so that's fantastic. Alright, so next up, we want to go ahead and get rid of the fire here, so that we can continue proceeding through the train. And we're just going to get rid of those little bits. Send them out of our path. There's another piece of luggage. Oh, okay. So I think that was that number four or was that number five? I think that was number four, correct? I'm pretty sure. All right, maybe we could do a team up move here. Actually, we need to fight a little bit. So let's get our meter charged up. And now it's time for a team-up move. Get ready, dude. Come on. Lao Fei. Do you not want to work with me? Buddy? Buddy, I would really appreciate it if we had a pretty cool team-up move, but I don't think it's going to be working here. So, let's just take these guys down with our combos here. Oh yeah? Check that out. Boom! That was a pretty cool attack from Scarlet Witch there. Alright. Just need to get rid of you. And we shall proceed to this area. Did we miss any of the luggage? There's got to be one more piece of luggage. And I think it's right there in the corner. I'm pretty sure. Hopefully that's it. Otherwise, we've missed it. Uh-oh. Yikes. Come on. Bring it on. Gotta fight these guys now. Oh, man. Okay. Okay. This is pretty ridiculous. Okay, there we go. Come on. Put together the little crossing there. Oh, now we can do the team-up move. What happened before? Why couldn't we do it? That was strange. All right, so there's our fifth and final piece of luggage. Again, as you saw, most of the luggage you'll just find along the way as you're walking through the train. But you have to keep in mind that one of the pieces of luggage is actually stuck in the final cart, the one that we found two minikits in to begin with. So again, to summarize, where should you be right now? Currently, you should have four minikits and two character tokens before we clear out this final area. Actually, let me go ahead and transform back to Lao Fei because I'm going to need to put out this fire here. Forgot about that. And now that we've done that, we just need Scarlet Witch to take control over the brakes and hopefully bring this thing to a halt. How did Lao Fei manage to freeze himself? I didn't even know that was possible. It's like, okay. Fascinating. Very, very weird. But okay. Alright, so here we are with the final area. This is going to be the area that has six more minikits, as well as Stanley, as well as a character token, and on top of that, we are also going to be getting the red brick. So there's a ton of stuff to do in this final area. So let's get to work here in just a moment. Those googly eyes. Let's do this. Here we go.
To help you put Jarvis into this thing.
No, not.
No.
Yeah.
Of course not.
Inside this.
Okay, good. Yeah, because I was going to say that would be very weird if we tried to transform Jarvis into a flying pig with cannons on its back. It's like, okay, and now to the rescue. Iron Pig. Iron Pig. Iron Pig.
Wait.
Does whatever an Iron Pig does. Uh-oh.
In any case, I'd suggest finding a way to get airborne.
Okay. Here we go. So, we have a little bit of trouble here. Right off the bat. Nice. Alright, excellent. So, let's get started here, shall we? I guess a pretty good starting point would be right over here. Just clear out all this stuff. And then, we need to do a detection scan. I wonder if Falcon can do that. Can you? No, he cannot. All right, let's go to Black Widow. Why not? We haven't played as her so far. Well, we did a little bit on the motorcycle chase scene. All right, for now, though, let's see what we got here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Got it. 1, 2, 3, and then 4. We got to melt this thing down. Okay, let's see. Maybe we can clear these guys out that way. There we are. Fantastic. Come on, we just took you down. Let's see the combo between the two lovely ladies. Aw, I thought it would be something like a little bit cooler. It would have been really nice if they would have given them some type of a cool combo. Okay, here we go. Let's melt this down. And would you look at that? A giant trash can was trapped behind that tiny little lock, and that unlocks us the final character token, which is Classic Mandarin. So very cool that he is actually in the game. We will get both the one that is from the Marvel Cinematic Universe, I should say, and also the classic one, which is obviously based more on the comic book version. All right, so let's discuss things with the collector here, see what he's up to and how may we help him, so to speak, in terms of making a trade for a red brick. So, hello, howdy, sir. How may I help thee?
Mind wondering what could the collector want in such a place? Fish.
Really?
Not just any
you
fish.
Want fish, dude?
This
okay.
Fish is renowned across the galaxy as one of the most
why would you
creatures within our existence.
That's disgusting, dude. I mean, I know collecting is like your thing, but why would you want to collect stinky fish just because it's the stinkiest fish of all? Like, that just does not seem like a really good idea at all. It's like,
What are you on about? It's like, I don't know. Whatever. I guess to each his own. To each his own. Can't really judge, so to speak. All right. How do we actually get the fish itself? How do you get the fish? We need to retrieve it. There we are. I think we've retrieved it. Oh, here we go. Let's do this. Time for a team-up move between these two. Oh, it's just the regular jumping move. I was kind of hoping it would be something a little bit cooler. All right. We need a character that can dig stuff. So let's use Black Panther. We haven't played as him in a while. All right. Ooh, look at that combo. Sweet. I didn't even know he could do that. That is such a cool move. So there's that stinky fish of his that he wants. We shall now return it to him. Never thought we'd be trading a valuable red brick for a stinky fish, but hey, sounds good. It's a pretty good trade for us, actually. Nothing to complain about. So, I thought the Ultron bot is just pushing him out of the way. All right, thank you. I do appreciate it. Thank you very much for that. Awesome. All right, so we got our red brick. Can we start moving now? There we are. Fantastic. Now, let's go ahead and clear out some of this stuff over here. Again, lots and lots of studs to be had there. Let's see. I wonder if Black Panther has any other combos. Is this the only combo that he has? I'm actually very intrigued to find out. I think so. I think that might be the only one that he can do. Is the one that we're currently doing. Maybe I'm wrong, obviously. Possible. Whoa, he can use deflection with the claws. That is cool. Did you see that when Iron Man was firing off? Or sorry, the Ultron bot was firing off shots at us. We actually blocked most of that stuff. So that was kind of cool. Very neat that you can actually do that. It's pretty cool. All right, can we break this stuff? Yes, we may. How much further can we break it apart? Can we break any of this? Nope, not quite. All right, well, let's put this thing together, I guess. For now. Actually, you know what? Before we even do that... Uh-oh. We gotta rescue those folks over there. So we'll be doing that in just a second here. I'm just gonna fly up to this area and show you how to rescue Stand-A-Man Lee. So all you need to do is just put out the fire right here. So once you've made it all the way up top, there he is. And he is now safe. So, yay! A job well done indeed. Uh-oh. Gotta watch out for these guys. They are not the kind of folks that you can talk out of a battle. They're very much intent on fighting things out for the most part. Okay, so we've cleared that now. And now we need a character that can mind control. So let's use... I'm trying to see. Who should we use? Let's use... let's use the leader. Why not? That should be pretty fun. Hello. Okay, wait a minute. Can we destroy this stuff or no? I don't think we can. All right. Well, let's just pull the switch. So there we go. Hopefully things will open on up. Excellent. And now we just take control over this situation. And put this thing together. Awesome. So we are kind of completing things along the way here. We're obviously trying to get the signal done up, so we got the first component of that done now, which is awesome. Now, I'm just going to take a quick little second right here to put out the flames in this area. And then put... Okay, I can't punch any of that. Okay. Put together a minikit. Yay! Awesome. So that is one of the minikits that I already had, so keep that in mind. That's why it didn't pop up as an actual minikit, and instead it just popped up as... a stud, so that's why that looked the way that it did. So you might be wondering right now, well, how many minikits should I have right now? I believe the count that you should have right now is 5. So if you have 5 minikits at this moment, all 3 character tokens and the Stan Lee rescued plus the red brick, you are golden. You're doing everything correctly and you've got the whole process figured out, so to speak, for the time being here. All right, so I believe that the blue stud that you just saw pop up there, that was another minikit right here in this little corner over in this area right there. So keep that in mind. And now we need to transform to another character. Caricature? Oh, no, wait a minute. There is our minikit. Let's see. So that wasn't the minikit. I could have sworn that that was the minikit that we already had. So which one did we already have then? Huh. Okay, I guess we're gonna have to figure that one out in a moment here. Can we go up here? I don't think we can go any higher, right? At least not right now. We did just get a couple of studs collected there, so that's pretty cool. Can we go into this area? Yay or nay? Come on. We're obviously destroying stuff inside that little area. I'm just wondering whether or not... Oh, I think we need to actually destroy the air conditioning unit first. I forgot about that. All right, so let's get rocket rolling. Back over to this area we go. And we need somebody with telekinetic powers once again. So let's go to the wizard. Why not? He might be able to help us with this task. So he shall take care of the vehicle here, which once is going to be disassembled. My goodness, these guys don't give up. There we go. Cool little combo from the wizard there. We shall put together a Captain America shield switch. And now we actually need to transform to a version of Captain America, such as the Sam Wilson version. And use the shield to open up this little door right here. I think this is the mini kit that we already had. It's actually the one in this area. Yep, this was... there was a mini kit right behind these actual crates and stuff. So once the crates open up, so that was another mini kit that we've collected. So right now you should be at 7 mini kits. This was one of the mini kits right here. Then there was a mini kit that we flew up and got from up in this area. And then there was the mini kit that we got from inside the train right here when we put out the fire. So keep that in mind. All right. So before we go up there and carry on, we are going to just destroy all this stuff really quickly. There we are. Now we need to put together a speed boost pad. Fantastic. We need a Quickster character. So let's go again to Quicksilver. I feel like we gotta play as Quicksilver. We're playing the Age of Ultron level, so I feel like we really do have to show him a little bit of love and make sure that he gets his time in the limelight. In the meantime, though, we're gonna use Curse here to clear this out. And now that we've done that, let's transform again. We need to put together a little grate. And excellent. Now we just need to phase through this thing. So let's do that. And Vision, may you please help us with this. Well, thank you for that. I do appreciate it. And that gets us our 8th mini kit, which is pretty awesome. And let's see. Now we shall drop on down to here. Whoops. And we're just going to kind of continuously jump on this little awning here. Okay, let's just melt all these guys down. Man, there's so many Ultron bots. It is crazy. All right, so we got to put together this little electricity panel. And now we need a character, that can actually charge that thing. So let's see. Did Stryker have the ability for electrical? Whoa, that was a cool combo, sir. Yep, he did have electrical charge abilities. So there we are. Fantastic. Oh, look at that. Would you look at that thing? That seems like it needs to be fixed up a little bit. So let's get it back to an operational status. And let's do this thing. We're going to use our new Scuba Iron Man to put this thing back together. And now that it's fully put together, it's kind of difficult to see because of Nova and everybody else having a bit of a battle over things. We're just gonna kind of drive this thing. Yikes. Come on, guys. Guys, I can't even go anywhere right now. You're all in the way. This is kind of crazy. Okie dokie. I was pretty sure that there's supposed to be studs that appear, but it's kind of difficult to do this when there is everything in the way. Everything that you could possibly think of is in the way. Oh, man. We were supposed to be following a pathway of studs, from what I understand. I just do not see any of these studs, which is a little bit disconcerting. Okie dokie. This is not good. This is not a good thing at all. Because I'm pretty sure we were supposed to get a pathway of studs. So you know what? Let's just actually clear these guys out, at least a few of them, because this is ridiculous. It's impossible to get around anywhere. And they're making so much noise, too, which doesn't help whatsoever. I don't know why I had such a weird accent there. Okay, so, let's see. We do have these little things here. Come on. Do we need to drive over these? I don't remember. I'm pretty sure we need to drive over the grates, because these weren't here before. And it did say one of three, did it not? So where's the second grate? We missed that one. There it was. Alright, so we haven't driven over that grate yet. Oh my goodness, they're not letting me back up now! You guys are unbelievable. You really are so mean! Okay, we're getting rid of these guys. Boom, boom, boom! See ya. No, 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 I did not want to switch characters! That was not what I wanted to do. Please move. Thank you. There we go. Ouch. Okay, can this thing pick itself up? Or is it basically done for now? Okay, thank you. I do appreciate that. And let's get back to properly driving you around. Careful. Come on. There we go. Alright, we did it. We've driven over all three grates. Whew. Okay, fantastic. So, that is a job well done. Now, let's see. Now that we're over here... Is this supposed to, like, take us up here or something? I'm not sure. Okie dokes. Are we supposed to destroy this thing? I can't remember now. Okay. Let's fight these guys, I guess. Let's see. We're gonna just try to separate ourselves. You know what, actually? Let's get in nice and close and get a combo move going if we can. Here we go. Let's do this, Iron Man. Take out all these fools. Oh, I have never been so annoyed at Ultron bots as I am right now. So I'm so happy that we've almost cleared out all of them. It's pretty awesome. All right, let's put this thing together. Now that we have the ladder assembled, we should be, I think that's going to actually trigger. Yep, there we go, the window breaking, which is what we wanted, of course. And now that that's done, we are going to actually fly ourselves up to this room, smash everything and get our 10th and final mini kit. Again, there is an insane amount of studs to be had in that room right there, so obviously collect all that. That is pretty awesome, and that will play quite a factor in your success in terms of being able to reach the True Avenger ranking without multipliers. With multipliers, it obviously doesn't really matter. I mean, even if you have times two, it's going to make things a lot easier. And honestly, considering that this is a later level in the game, by now you probably should have acquired at least a couple of the multipliers. I mean, they really, really help, so why not go ahead and take advantage of that? It really helps you out, so why not go ahead and try to enjoy the benefits of it. Alright, so let's use Black Widow here to get this thing into an operational status, even though technically at this point in time she wasn't even here anymore. Look at this combo right here. Look at that cool combo between Iron Man and Black Widow. That was sweet. That was awesome. And of course, that also will wrap up the level. So we did a pretty good job on level 13. And we get to take off safely and move on to fight another day, so to speak. Career Prospects is now level completed, which is absolutely awesome. There it is, as it says right there on the screen. So that is fantastic. We earned over 1 billion studs there, thanks to our multipliers, of course. And that obviously earns us the True Avenger ranking. So that is awesome sauce. Fantastic, super happy about that. There's Komodo, so thankfully I was correct about that character. I wasn't sure if it was Komodo. The Mandarin in his classic outfit, as well as Ultron Prime. So there are three versions of Ultron in the game. There's Prime, Ultimate Ultron, and Mark One Ultron. So pretty cool that we actually get three variations of him, just like we saw in the film. Stan Lee's obviously no longer in Pearl. We got the Red Brick, plus we collected all 10 minikits, which will now reassemble themselves into hopefully a pretty cool comic book page. So let's see what we got. Come on. I wonder what it's going to be. It might be something to do... Oh, okay. Very cool. We got Black Widow there looking quite stylish. I was going to say, it might be something to do with Scarlet Witch or Quicksilver, because this is when they turn to our side and become good guys, so to speak. And we obviously earn the two additional gold bricks that we were missing. But keep in mind, If you were to rescue Stanley for the very first time, you would have earned an extra gold brick for that, which would have given you all 4 gold bricks for that level. So with that in mind, ladies and gents, there you have it. I hope that you guys obviously enjoyed today's episode. If you did, please don't forget to leave a like. And I will catch you guys next time as we head on to Rise of Ultron, the next level in the game. And that means that, of course, there's only 2 more levels for us to tackle, and we will be 100% completed on the game, which is pretty cool indeed. With that in mind, ladies and gents, as always, have an absolutely fantastic day. Don't forget to drop a like if you guys enjoyed the video and found it helpful. Let's go ahead and aim for 1,000 likes. I will obviously hopefully catch you guys here on the next one. Peace out. See you later, alligators. Bye-bye, everyone.